Ladies and gentlemen, after a year of delay and after a couple months of delay, we finally get the album we've been waiting for. I know for the past couple years or so, Kanye West has been through a lot. At the beginning of last year, he said some stuff about siding with Trump, not on his policies, but siding with the idea that he ran for president and actually won. And I wasn't really feeling him supporting Trump in that type of sense. But last year, he came out with Ye. He talked about how he dealt with mental health problems, his bipolar disorder, and he's been through a lot. He's been through the hospital. He almost went through a divorce with Kim Kardashian. It's been a rough time. The death of his mother has actually shown and has been apparent throughout his music lately, and I really felt bad for him when everybody was like, man, F Kanye, cancel Kanye. I was one of the few that was like, hey man, let this man live. He obviously needs to heal, dealing with stuff in his life. So I'm not gonna really bash him, cancel him. I hate cancel culture anyway. I don't see how you really could cancel anybody. But I really felt bad for Kanye, and many people were not rocking with him. But this album came out. This is apparently supposed to be a gospel album. And from the snippets I was hearing from the listening parties in New York, Detroit, it definitely sounds like it was heavily gospel influenced. And I think he's going to rap a little bit on this. I don't know how much rapping he's going to rap on this, but he's definitely going to rap on this. And I took a look at the Jesus is King movie. And when I tell you, that is one of the most beautiful things I've seen this year. That film was just a pure art film full of visuals, the Sunday service choir. And I'm really a big fan of the Sunday service. I really watched the Coachella Sunday service performance by Kanye West and the choir. And it was just moving. Some of the parts almost made me cry. And I'm really looking forward to listening to this album. So I just want to get to this. Jesus is King, Kanye West. Let's get it. Before we listen to this album, I just wanted to let everybody know, whether you believe in God or not, let's come in this with an open mind, because some of the music might be great. You might be moved by some of the music that's going to be played on this album. I know some people don't rock with God. I know some people rock with God a lot, but if you don't believe in God, or if you do believe in God, let's come in this with an open mind. Let's not judge anybody based off their past actions or based on what they're going through or what they're talking about. So let's just keep that in mind while listening to this. So Kanye West, Jesus King, let's get it. First track, Every Hour, featuring the Sunday Service Choir. Ooh, yes, turn me up real quick. The run. Yes. This is so uplifting. Yes. Yes. That track was Every Hour, and it was just so uplifting. I love the Sunday service. Once again, the choir is beautiful. Hitting them runs, it reminds me of sitting in church in those days where the choir would just go ham. That's basically what it was, the choir going ham on that track. Nothing too crazy. It was beautiful, beautiful. But we're just getting started. On to the second track called Sail, which has been one of the most anticipated tracks on this album. So let's get it, baby. I love the organ chord on this.
When I get to heaven's gates, I ain't gotta peek over.
Ha.
Keeping perfect composure. When I scream at the chauffeur,
yeah.
I ain't mean I'm just focused.
Mm.
Before the flood, people judge. They did the same thing to Noah. Everybody wanted Yandy.
Yes.
Jesus Christ did the laundry. They say that we start on Monday, but the strong start on Sunday.
Yes.
Well, the descendants of Abraham, they should be.
Oh snap. Come on, choir. Oh my gosh. Come on. Oh my gosh. That choir. my gosh.
If you broke, don't wake up.
Yes.
With Judas kissing makeup. Even with the bitter cup. Gave my brothers a drink up. Ain't no want, no we need it.
Yes.
Time to be the big greedy.
Yes.
We need ours by this evening.
Yes.
No, we got the product. We got the tools. We got the money.
Come on, yay. Come on, yay.
We on the loose. People is lying. We are the truth.
Come on, yay.
Oh, mommy and God, and we are the truth.
Woo. Oh, come on, yay. Come on. Come on, yay! Come on now! That track just sounded like the gates of heaven just opened up. The gates are opening. You see God, the angels just screaming, hallelujah. It sounds epic. It sounds like something out of a movie. You could put that in a war scene. Everybody's going out for blood. You could put that when people are transcending up to heaven. That's what it literally sounds like. That track, Sailor, man, that's the best one so far. So far. We're 2 for 2, baby. We're 2 for 2. We're only 2 tracks in. It's 11 songs. It's a short album, 27 minutes. But Sailor, man, oh my, the hallelujahs. That made it for me. And Kanye, bro. Kanye on his rapping part with the drums. It was beautiful. Third track, Follow God. Oh, snap. I hear the sample. Oh, yay, coming back up, man. Come on. No, sir. We're running back. We're running back. This is Oh Yay, ladies and gentlemen. We got to stand up. This is Oh Yay. Come on now. Come on. He keeps going. Let's go.
Nothing else next though. Not another word, let a picture or a decimal. With God, I don't really want to rest, so they said it ain't Christ-like.
Come on, yay. He kept going. Come on, yay is back, Yeezy season. Let's go.
Spazzing on me, I start spazzing back. He said, it ain't Christ-like. I said, ah!
Follow God, man. Follow God. It's a banger. He got me sweating in here. Why did I wear this long sleeve? But he got me sweating. And that sample, it sounds like Father Stretch My Hands Part 3, man. Kanye, his flow in that. I'll be on Instagram and I don't even like likes. Y'all wrote off Kanye a year ago. It's funny to me how y'all could write him off, quote unquote, cancel him. And he makes stuff like this. He's going through a journey. Let's respect it, ladies and gentlemen. But anyways, probably one of the crowd favorites from the listening party that I heard of. Closed on Sunday. Supposed to have the Chick-fil-A line in this. I can't wait. Let's get it. Ooh. My gosh. Them little voices in the back. This is beautiful. I like the harp too.
Sunday.
Uh-huh.
You my Chick-fil-A.
Ha-ha.
The grandma way.
Mm.
Get your family.
Yes.
Y'all hold hands and pray.
Mm.
When you're my number one. With the lemonade.
Oh. You're my number one with the lemonade. I gotta be honest here, yay. I get the spicy chicken sandwich. I don't get the number one, the regular one. I get the spicy one. So if you would have said spicy with the lemonade, I would have felt that one. I still do.
Hey. No more living for the culture, we nobody slave.
Yes!
Stand up for my home. Bow down to the king upon the throne. My
yes.
Seat and I ain't playing.
Yes.
Now, back up off my family, move your hands.
Yes!
Jezebel don't even stand a chance.
Haha, yes! Close on Sunday. That's going to be a lot of Instagram captions. I could tell for a lot of people. Close on Sunday. You're my Chick-fil-A. Next track, we got On God, which is one of my most favorite anticipated tracks on this album because I heard Pierre did production on this album and the snippet to this was, it sounds like a banger. So let's get to it. On God, let's get it. That's your love that labor not to bad. I'm a bad, that's on God. Yeah. And all my brothers locked up on the yard. You could still be anything you wanna be. That's facts. Went from 1-4 to 1-3. Yes. Oh my God. That's on Keith. That's on Keith. That's on sin. Candy changes statues. That's on pride. Oh my God. Buster, that's on tribe. Oh. When I thought the book of Job was a job. Oh my God. People have my soul. I can't lie. Yes. This sounds like a video game, bro. Oh my. So God, come on. Yes. The greatest artist resting on alive. He said it. That's on LA Reed. It's so good. No, I cannot let my family starve. No, sir. Yes. That's a banger. On God is a banger. Pierre on a production made it sound like it was a video game. I was like, wow. Then that synth came in. Then I had the vocals from the Mercy track. Okay, Lamborghini Mercy. Bro, that line when Kanye said, I bleach my hair every time that I thought I would die, that hit me. He said I would do it for my fam. I can't let them starve, man. So on God, then he had the catchy bar with the that's on Keith, that's on Chief. That song, bro, that song was amazing. That was a banger to me. But the next track, Everything We Need, originally it was supposed to have XXXTentacion on the track, and it was called The Storm, featuring Ty Dolla $ign and Ant Clemens. Ant Clemens, he slept on. I'm probably going to do a video on him up next because he has an amazing, beautiful voice, and he's been on multiple Kanye songs on his previous album, so I can't wait to hear this one.
Switch your attitude. Go ahead, level up yourself. Feel that feeling, enjoy yourself. Cause we have everything we need.
Oh, and those vocals, bro, amazing.
What if we made apple juice? You gon' do what Adam do? Or say, baby, let's put this back on the tree. Cause
yes! Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! Ty Dolla $ign, come on now. Yeah, that track was beautiful. Ty Dolla $ign's vocals made it so heavenly, psychedelic type of vocals. Every time Kanye and Ty Dolla $ign link up, it's a hit. But Ant Clemens, his voice was so amazing. The way he came in on that with his auto-tune, it was beautiful. It was beautiful, man. Kanye did his thing with that Adam and Eve bar. I love that a lot. But next track, we got Water, which debuted at Coachella during Kanye West's Sunday Service performance. I was vibing to the song, but I haven't heard the like high-definition quality sound or the CDQ version of the song. So I can't wait to hear this one. Water, Kanye West, featuring Ant Clemens, who bodied that other track, and hopefully he bodied this one. So let's get it. This sounds kind of jazzy a little bit.
The glory in our conversation.
Yes.
Your light reflect on me. I promise I'm not hiding anything. It's water.
Come on, Ant.
Pure as water, like a newborn daughter. A storm may come, but we'll get through.
Come on.
Like water.
This is beautiful. This is beautiful.
Jesus, flow through us. Jesus, heal the bruises.
Come on, yay.
Jesus, clean the music. Jesus, please use us. Jesus, please help.
Yes.
Jesus, please heal.
Yes.
Jesus is our rock. Jesus, give us grace. Jesus, keep us safe.
Lead us like the rain is rain. Come on now.
I promise I'm not hiding anything. It's water.
Oh my gosh. So beautiful, man. And Clemens. Oh my gosh. That sounds heavily. This is beautiful. Water was a beautiful track. I could tell it's gonna heal a lot of people. Basically talking about how water is pure, you can see through it, and basically reflects what you do in your life. And I think this track is talking about how Kanye describes how God, what he's doing in his life, and how it reflects the way he's acting now and reflects his new journey of life and walking with Christ. And I'm all here for it. That was a beautiful track, and Aunt Clement stole the show once again with that track. I love his vocals in there, and the choir just sound so heavily in there. I heard the water in the background. It was just a beautiful track overall. It was kind of a jazzy type of fusion for Kanye West, but I loved Water a lot. But the next track, called God Is. The gospel sample, this sound like about to be some oh yay. A beautiful track. That's probably one of Kanye West's best songs in his discography. That was such a beautiful track telling his journey to finding God, and I'm really here for that. I'm really here for his spiritual journey. I could tell that song was very hard for him to do. I could hear the pain in his voice. That sample, God Is by James Cleveland, was beautiful. I love Kanye singing in falsetto. It just shows how much pain that he has. That just moved me personally. But God is probably top three for me so far in this album. Next track, we got Hands On featuring Fred Hammond, who is a prominent gospel artist. And Kanye West has used some of his songs in his Sunday service performances. And so I'm curious to see how this is going to sound.
Cut out all the lights, see the light. Got pulled over, see the brights.
Yes.
Made a left when I should have made a right.
Tell him.
Told God last time on life.
Ha.
Told the devil when I see him on sight.
Yeah, on sight.
I've been working for you my whole life.
Told
the devil that I'm going on a strike. Said I'm finna do a gospel album.
Yeah.
What have you been hearing from the Christians?
They'd
be the first one to judge me. Be the first one to judge me. Feeling like nobody loved me.
Sad.
Told people God was my mission.
Yeah.
What have you been hearing from the Christians?
Somebody pray for me.
Fred Hammond. Come on now.
I deserve all the criticism you get. If that's all the love you have, that's all you get. Joking, to praise his name, you ask what I'm smoking.
Come on, Fred. Could tell that this track was kind of Justin Vernon, Bon Iver inspired with the vocals from Fred Hammond and Kanye West. But Kanye, he touches upon how he making gospel music now, and he's creating a gospel album, and how Christians' reactions to him making this album and going through his journey. He says that most Christians are not accepting of what he's doing with this album and his journey with his faith. And that's just sad to me that people judge you just because you're going on the type of journey that they're living, and they feel like they have a place into telling you whether you should believe this or not, bro. I respect everybody who believes what they believe. Honestly, not my place or anybody else's place to tell you what you should do or what you should believe, because at the end of the day, you know, we're our own people and we're our own self, so we have to think for ourselves. Like, don't let anybody else influence what you think or what you believe in. I love that track. I really love how minimalistic it was. It was mostly centered around vocals, and his distortion and auto-tune part of his vocals made it seem like he was going through something. That's gonna be one of those tracks that people are gonna skip over, but later come back to it and realize that how fire it really is. So I really love Hands On. Next track, ladies and gentlemen, I've been waiting for this since the leaks happened. I've listened to a snippet of these at the listening parties. And man, when I tell you, snippets were fire, bro. But I haven't heard clips, and clips are reunited. Pusha T and No Malice are finally reunited after years of not rapping together. Clips is an underrated rap duo. They're honestly one of the best rap duos in rap history. And Kenny G on the saxophone? And this, I can't wait to hear it. Uses gospel, formerly known as Law of Attraction or Chakras. Let's get it, baby. I can't wait to hear this. Oh my gosh, let's get it.
Use this gospel protection. It's a hard road to heaven.
Yes.
We call on your blessings. The kingdom.
Yes.
Our demons are trembling.
Yes. Holy. My gosh. This sounds beautiful, y'all.
Could he not be the greatest?
Push!
In my bed undercovers when undercovers had raided.
Come on!
Glad that you made it.
Whew.
The best is yet to come, I'm just glad that you waited.
Yes!
They all said it real till it's time to appraise it. But who am I to judge? I'm crooked as Vegas.
Come on! Push!
Kingdom! Our demons are trembling.
Holy angels
defending.
Let's go!
A lot of damaged souls, I done damaged
those. Ooh, and then
the Americans took a camera pole.
Yes!
Caught with a trunk, a berry man alone. From the concrete grew a rose.
Cool.
I give you rave talk, I give you faith talk. Brother, when is faith lost?
Kenny G. Oh, I'm done, bro. I'm done. Kenny! Come on now! Come on! Bells! That was the one. Use this gospel. Yeah, that was the one. Ye did it again. People tried to cancel him, write him off. He did it again with this album. We're on the last track, Jesus is Lord. I heard this in a Jesus is King film. Amazing film, beautiful film. They had an extended version of this song, which was amazing. Amazing. I wish he would have put this version on this album. It's Jesus is Lord, last track of the album.
Every knee shall bow.
Beautiful, bro. Kanye West, Jesus is King, man. This album is beautiful. I know many people don't believe in God, whether you believe in God or not, bro. You have to respect the artistry of Kanye West. Kanye never fails when it comes to making albums. To me, he has never missed on an album. I know people are not gonna initially like this album. I know this because when 808s and Heartbreak came out, Jesus came out, Life of Pablo came out, Ye came out, people were not feeling those albums at first. Years later, we regard 808s and Heartbreak as a game changer in hip hop. We see Jesus as something that broke the system, that broke the matrix, and that paved the way for so many people. The Life of Pablo is now a great album. People are still warming up to Ye, but I believe that Jesus is King is going to be one of those albums where people realize probably years, 5 or 6 years later, that this is a classic album. To me, this is what sets apart Kanye for the rest of his peers. Kanye never fails to lay it out all on the line when it comes to making music. Despite of everything he's been through throughout his mental health issues, the Trump situation, whether it was his mom dying, him getting his car accident, he always uses these events in his life to formulate a great form of art. This kind of reminds me of Jesus in a sense. Jesus the King kind of juxtaposes Jesus in a sense. They're two complete polar opposites, but have the same type of concept. Jesus was based off of his ego and his journey of his ego getting the best of him. But at the end, he finds his wife, Kim Kardashian. He loves something other than himself. He finds refuge in his wife, for the love of his wife. In this album, it talks about his journey and his walk through God and how he got through that. And now at the end, he finds that God restores his faith. He finds love in God rather than himself. Production of the album was beautiful and amazing. You have songs like Everything We Need, Water. God is probably one of the best Kanye West songs. I'm saying it right now. God is one of his best songs. Uses Gospel, man. Uses Gospel was iconic, legendary. Selah was a song that is epic. Selah is one of the best songs on the album. And you have tracks like Follow God, which reflects the ODA. Like when he get into sample bag and just rapping and flowing. This is not a gospel album that is preachy. And it didn't come off as that to me personally. It came off as a Kanye West album that has gospel elements to it and that has hip hop elements into it. It was just a beautiful masterpiece. People are not gonna rock with this. People are not gonna rock with this at first. But years down the line, I think people are gonna realize that this is a classic. And I'm saying it right now, this is a classic. This is a classic Ye album, and it's been on repeat for the past couple days for me. But Jesus is King, great, beautiful album. Let me know what you think down in the comment section down below. Did you love Jesus is King? Did you hate it? Give it a few more listens if you do not believe in God or whatever. I would still say listen to it because something in there might move you. Not necessarily, you know, convince you to believe in God, but it is beautiful music. I would suggest for all of you to listen to it multiple times because on the first listen, it might not hit you. You might have to listen to it 3, 4, 5, maybe even 6 times to even like it or love it. This album, I think, is going to stand the test of time. It's going to be an album for life. Not only an album of the year, but album for life. So I rock with this album. Let me know what you think down in the comment section down below. It's your boy. We out.